friends. Namaste.
Namaste.
Namaste. It's an old favorite.
Om Asatoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Om Asatoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya Mrityorma Satoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Om Satoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Satoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Om Satoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Satoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Om Satoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Satoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Om Satoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Satoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Om Satoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Om Satoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Om Satoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Om Satoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya Satoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyoti Agamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya.
Gatherings are becoming deeper and deeper. That reminds me of a song.
Can you hear the woodpecker? Maybe not, huh?
Well, David told me today this is our 30th, I think, or 31st. What was it?
Tomorrow is our 33rd.
Our 33rd. So today is our 32nd gathering together.
And it's also Isabella's 18th birthday, and we want to wish you a beautiful birthday. I think we saw each other last 18 years ago in Costa Rica.
Yeah, that's nice.
And so it's a full circle.
Isabella's birthday, and at the same time,
oh, yes,
it's my grandson Milo's birthday today, and
11.
He's 11. How old is how old?
Yep.
No, the lady you just said.
Isabella.
Isabella.
He's
18. 18.
18.
Yeah. Oh my God! I thought you said 80. Just put a few years on you, Isabella. Happy birthday. I'm going to sing this song for Milo and for Isabella today as we have birthdays. And even though they're a few years apart, I think this song applies. It's a song I wanted to put in as many wishes as I could, you know, as many prayers as I could. Song. It's like, I know many of you grandparents and grandchildren not able to have any physical contact right now, and that's so sad. That's really so, it's such a human thing for the grandchildren and the grandparents to connect, and there's a whole energetic connection there that is unique, and for that to be postponed for a while, I know it's tough. Personally, I'm more of a Skype granddad. So, Milo, if you're watching this, happy birthday, mate.
Yes,
and,
happy birthday.
I love you so much. I wish you love. I wish you good health. And I wish you the company of your own true self. And I wish you peace when the day is done, when the shadows fall and the evening comes. But this is my prayer, don't despair now, prepare for a miracle. This is my prayer, don't despair, prepare for a miracle. Ooh, it's just a breath away. It's just a breath away. Mother's touch, your father's crazy wisdom, you know it means so much. And I wish you a special friend, your secrets to hold as you travel through life together and your stories unfold. Well, now this is my prayer, don't despair, prepare for a miracle. This is my prayer, don't despair, prepare for a miracle. Ooh, it's just a breath away. It's just a breath away. To really love, to keep your heart open when life gets rough. And I pray this song will touch your heart, so we'll be together though we're far apart. Now this is my prayer, now don't despair, prepare for a miracle. This is my prayer, don't despair, prepare for a miracle. Ooh, it's just a breath away. It's just a breath. This is my prayer. This is my prayer. Don't despair. Prepare for a miracle. This is my prayer. Don't despair. Prepare for a miracle. Ooh, it's just a breath. Just a breath away. So never give up, 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 never give up. Prepare for a miracle. Never give up.
is just a breath away. I say it's just a breath away. It's just a
It's time for our meditation.
Did you try that suggestion out to chant the Om or Aum sound as you fall asleep in the evening? It's such a beautiful way to leave the day behind and to leave the thoughts about the day behind and just tune into the moment and fill the body with the sound Om on every out breath and have that carry us into sleep and carry us all through the night into the next day. Check it out. It's something we do every night. It's not something that we can master the first time because it's quite challenging to stay conscious as long as we can.
Some of you might be new to meditation. I know when I look at the comments, there are many new friends joining us every day, and we'll just take a moment now to prepare. The one thing about meditation, and the most important thing, is that we can make friends with our inner sanctuary, to ourselves. The reason people find it difficult to meditate is because when we close our eyes, we're anxious, we're a little irritable sometimes, or we want to move our bodies and we don't really want to just sit and do nothing. We've got so much to do in life that to sit and do nothing is pretty low in the priorities. But in fact, it's the most important thing. Because if we're not at peace with ourselves, then how the hell are we going to be at peace with how is the world going to be at peace? How are we going to be at peace? If we're looking for someone else to make us peaceful, we're looking in the wrong place, you know? So, it's not easy, and it doesn't come cheap, and it's not free, because it requires our attention and our intention and our energy and our trust. Because at first, we just feel like, oh, my mind is going crazy. I'm not doing this. I can't meditate, you know. Have a little faith.
Mm.
Have a little trust. Just keep coming back to just being aware of the sounds in your room, maybe the sounds of people next door, maybe the sounds outside, sounds of someone in another room in your house. All these sounds, whatever they are, they're just part of God's orchestra. And if we can find a place where we can sit and breathe and relax and just let all these sounds that we're not hearing, we're listening for them. So we actually listen. if you just take a moment now, maybe let's just prepare now for our meditation. So get yourself comfortable, get your body comfortable. And close your eyes. Once we close our eyes, we're alone. And there's a beautiful thing about aloneness. Aloneness is not loneliness. Loneliness is a negative. To be alone is where we are. If we can connect with our aloneness, we feel the oneness of everything. It's the distraction that makes us lonely. If we can feel our aloneness by closing our eyes, coming home to the body, taking a deep breath and just using a moment to listen to all the sounds. Let's start there. And of course, taking a deep breath. That we're thinking about the future or remembering something of the past, just let those thoughts go. Let them be like clouds and just focus on the blue sky, the vast empty sky. And that's where the key is. It's not following the clouds. Let the clouds go. Don't hold on to any thoughts. Don't verbalize your thoughts. Experiment by raising your gaze to your third eye. Behind your closed eyes, just raising your gaze up. That's where the deep blue sky is. Beyond the clouds, it's there. You can look with your third eye into space. There's nothing there. Of course, mantras are a great key because we are verbalizing a healing sound that takes us into meditation purely because of its nature. So with our back straight, so we have a sense of intention, we're not in any way it's not a comfortable thing. It's not something where you can lounge, unless you're the Dalai Lama, of course, or something like that. Mm-hmm. But for us mortals, it's good to keep our back straight, you know? It feels different. Relax your shoulders. And coming back to listening. We can begin with the meditation, and the meditation, as usual, is a sequence of humming the mantra Om, and then chanting the Gayatri Mantra, seven chakra, and Deva will lead you through the different chakras as we chant them, and then we will move back to the Om for the end of the meditation. And if you can do with your eyes closed, fantastic. And the secret is not to be serious. Be joyful. Be playful. Be grateful. Be thankful.
take a deep breath. Let's breathe out. And then a deep breath.
Sound to resonate in your body with the sound. Bring the sound into your body, feeling the resonation, the resonance. Deep breath. Sound into your body.
source of all things, and the source is the all these seven levels that we are invoking, that we are harmonizing, and that are reflected in the seven chakras in our bodies. That's the cosmos, the inner cosmos that's reflected in the outer. So we can actually physically touch each one of these energy centers as we move up through the seven chakras when we sing each sound. So for the first chakra, it's Om Bu. So you can find a place to touch your first chakra. Actually, we're sitting on our first chakra, so find a place either in the front or the back that feels most appropriate. So that's Om Bu. Om Bu Baha is the second chakra, which is just below the navel. Om Bu Baha. Third chakra is the solar plexus. Om Svaha. Fourth chakra, the heart chakra, is where the heart is, in the middle of the chest. Om Maha. Fifth chakra is the throat chakra. It's in this base of the throat. Om Janaha. Sixth chakra, Om Tapaha. It's the third eye chakra. Om Tapaha. And then the seventh chakra, it's the truth realm. Satya means truth. That's the thousand-petaled lotus. It's where there's no more duality, and we are aware of our oneness with everything. So if it helps you, maybe even stand up, because you're more free with your arms, you can let your body move more, and actually even find your own mudra with each chakra if you feel. And if not, otherwise just put your hands on each chakra as we move on.
Thank you.
mi turbaria pargo diva sia di me Dio Iona praccio dai.
Open. Just take a moment, close your eyes now, come home. And feel that smile in your belly and the open sky from your third eye. In arms with our brothers and sisters across the world. Baby. I think there's a baby. David told me she saw what looked like a little baby in the nest.
Definitely.
Yeah, you did. I think that's why everybody's so happy around here. All the birds are celebrating the birth of a little what's it called?
Baby bird. It's a Kiskadee. It's called a great Kiskadee bird.
Beautiful. It's got yellow, bright yellow breast and black and white head and brown wings.
Yeah, it's quite
something. And
that's not it, that's a different word. I just wanted to also give you a little maybe help, because I remember when I was first started meditating, like in my teen, and as a teenager, I realized, and I still have that now, that feeling like I sit and I think, this is not meditation. I'm thinking all the time, you know, meditation is supposed to be complete peace or quiet, and only when that happens am I really meditating. And But I definitely feel different afterwards, and that's when I see that something that I haven't just done anything, that I have nourished the peace inside me or increased the peace inside me with this hour of sitting, even though it felt maybe like it was an hour of thinking. And somehow there's so many things in life where the aftertaste is really the key to how good they are for us. You know, like if we watch something, does it leave us uplifted or does it leave us drained? Meditation, you know, we really feel it afterwards for sure, you know. So just not to beat ourselves up if we feel we're not peaceful enough or thoughtless enough, or, you know, this is not real meditation. It's a practice, and that's why it's called a meditation practice, because we do it again and again to practice.
There's a great analogy about the man who was digging for water, and digging for days and days and days, and going deeper and deeper and getting more and more despondent. And just at that moment when he felt like, that's it, there's no water here, just at that moment he struck water. And it's a bit like that, you know. You just think, oh, I'm going to stop tomorrow. But there is no escape from ourselves. So we have to eventually come to that point of self-realization and relaxed awareness. Meanwhile, we continue on in this very strange situation, which I hope you're making the most of. I think the most important thing is to look to see what we can find in the situation that we're in that gives us some sense of satisfaction or psychological freedom or laughter. It can be many different things. A feeling of being intensely in the moment, if we're listening or if we're painting or if we're writing or whatever we're doing. If we can stay in the moment, even cleaning the house, it's all art. It's all a sacred action. And in the ashram we used to call it worship, because it was a form of worship. We were giving back and giving thanks in everything we did, and I like that understanding. So we never called it work, even though we were engaged in much activity all through our lives. We always looked on it as worship, and you just couldn't get enough. It was great. So if anybody asked me to play, if people asked me to play in Buddha Hall for Osho, it would just be the most beautiful thing I could imagine to do. So, and I think that's what we're still doing. We're, in a way, we're all worshipping the great divine. Doesn't have a name, it doesn't have a face, unless it's Deva, of course. It does.
And tomorrow we have our global day of unity, which happens once a month. This is the second time that it happens, and this is what we were going to do anyway all year, and anyway contribute to all year, which means that we're going to chant the Gayatri Mantra 108 cycles tomorrow for our meditation. So and there will be some other events happening too. We'll share them on our Facebook site, and we'll see each other tomorrow.
Uplift is great. You should check it out. UPLIFT. Check it out.
Dot connect.
And there's some really they're really good people doing some great things. So check that out. And we're happy to be part of it tomorrow. Okay.
Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Om shanti shanti
Shanti.
Namaste, everyone.
Namaste.
Blessings.